Have you ever tried installing Linux on external SSD? Well, this is the best way to run Linux on any PC or laptop before installing it on the main system. Now, with this method, you don't have to disrupt the Windows computer or its partitions. Instead, you can install Linux on external SSD connected via USB 3 port. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install Arch Linux on external SSD. Using this method, you can have a portable Linux environment with different distributions without affecting the main system. For this project, you need an 8 gigs or larger pen drive to create a bootable USB with desired Linux distribution. Additionally, you need external SSD of 120 GB or higher. They can be connected to the computer via a USB 3 port. Now, for this demonstration, I will be using my HP Pavilion gaming laptop running Windows 11 operating system. Now, this is the external SSD that I'm going to connect to the Windows 11 computer. This is where we are going to install Linux shortly. Now, on your Windows computer, open your favorite browser and download the Linux distribution of your choice. Now, based on my testing, Pop OS, Ubuntu, and Arch Linux performed very well. Now, therefore, I recommend Arch Linux for better results. I'm going to download Arch Linux ISO. Now, once it's downloaded, proceed to download Balena Etcher and install it. Next, connect your pen drive to the computer and open Balena Etcher. Then click on Flash from a File and import the Linux ISO. Then select a target device and choose your USB pen drive. Now, once it's done, click on Flash and wait for some time for the bootable USB with Linux to be created. Now go ahead and restart your computer. While it's rebooting, you need to enter into BIOS settings. Now use the keyboard shortcut based on your motherboard. Now usually, it could be F2, F9, or Escape key. The first thing to do after entering into BIOS is to enable USB boot. Then change the boot order by setting the USB drive as a primary boot device. You go ahead and disable secure boot, which is very important. Otherwise, Arch Linux may not boot. If you have any option like Microsoft third-party UEFI, go ahead and enable it. It's also recommended to clear any keys or certificates after disabling the secure boot. Now, this way, it won't cause any installation problems. Now, once it's done, save the changes. Now, your system will boot into Arch Linux from the pen drive. If in case it fails to boot, use the boot menu to load Arch Linux installation media. Now, when you see this screen, you can choose the first option to boot into the Arch Linux installer. If the installer falls back to this menu, highlight the first option and press the letter E on your keyboard to enter into editor mode. Then locate the Linux and go to the end of this line and add an argument called no mode set. Now press F10 to lower the kernel with the new argument. Now this will disable the iGPU or NVIDIA GPU and loads the installer in safe graphics mode. You now see that it has successfully booted into the Arch Linux installation setup. The first thing is to check for a stable internet connection. If your computer is connected to the internet via Ethernet, you can use the ping command to check the connection. If your computer has built-in Wi-Fi support, you can use iwctl tool to connect to the internet. To use iwctl, simply type iwctl in the terminal to enter the iwd shell mode, then type the device list to see a list of network interfaces. Now look for WLAN0 and then type station space WLAN0 space get dash networks to see the list of Wi-Fi networks. Now next, run this command and enter the name of your Wi-Fi network. Then press the return key and input the Wi-Fi password. After entering the password, wait for 5 seconds and press enter to connect to the internet. You might not see any output, but if the connection was successful, you can exit the IWD mode. That's it. You have successfully connected to the internet and are ready to proceed with the Arch Linux installation process. Now run the ping command to ensure you are receiving the packets. Now, as you can see, I have connected to my computer via SSH. Now type pacman-sy to synchronize the system packages and upgrade them to the latest version. Then run this command to install the Arch Linux keyring package. Now afterward, install the Arch installer script with this command. Now type arch install to trigger the installer script. The arch install script makes the Arch Linux installation process faster and easier. Now use the arrow keys to navigate through the options, then set the system language by selecting your preference. The first three options can be left at their default values. Next, choose the disk configuration. Opt for the first option and select the external SSD where you want to install Arch Linux by pressing either the spacebar or the tab key. You will see an asterisk between the square brackets indicating the drive selection. Then press the Enter key and choose BTRFS as the file system for the installation. If you wish to secure your installation with encryption, you can set an encryption password. Now next, select the bootloader. You can choose between the systemd or the grub bootloader. I will choose grub, then I will leave the swap value set as true and keep the hostname as Arch Linux. Now after that, set the root password and assign a password for the root user. Then create a new user account. You can even add the new user to the sudoers list for elevated privileges. Now choose to confirm and exit. It's time to install the desktop environment. Select the profile option and then choose desktop. While the Arch install script offers numerous options, for the demonstration, I will select the Qtfish desktop environment. Next, choose the graphic drivers that you want to install. If you have a dedicated NVIDIA graphics card, choose the proprietary or Nauru driver accordingly. The AMD user should choose AMD or ATI open source. Then select the audio option and choose the audio server. For best results on most computers, it's recommended to use Pipewire. If you wish, you can also install additional kernels, but for now, I will stick with the default or the latest kernel. In the additional packages section, you can specify a list of tools to be installed, separated by spaces. Now after that, configure the network and choose to use the network manager. Finally, select your time zone to set the correct time on your system. Now check that all the options and have not left anything blank. Once you have confirmed, select the install option and press enter and wait for a few minutes for Arch Linux to be fully installed on your computer. And that's it. With these simple steps, you have successfully installed Arch Linux using the Arch install script. Now, once the installation is complete, a prompt for post-installation steps will appear. Select yes to enter the chroot environment and start customizing your new Arch Linux installation. Now install useful tools such as Firefox, LibreOffice, and more. When you finish installing, exit the secured environment and type reboot to restart your computer. Now, after the screen goes black, remove the USB pen drive, ensuring that the external SSD is still connected. The computer should automatically boot into Arch Linux from external SSD. Now, when you turn on your computer with an external SSD connected via USB, it will boot into Linux. Now, once you are done working with Linux, shut down the PC, eject the external SSD, and turn it back on to boot into Windows 11 automatically. And that's pretty much it. This is how you install Linux on an external SSD. Now give it a try and let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching. This has been KSK Ryle. I will see you in the next one.